Pinpoint, bringing you the very best of the internet. Welcome to Pinpoint. If you've ever needed to view and control your Android device from your Windows PC, but never could find a solution that wasn't premium or required you to jump through a bunch of hoops, add this one to your list, it might come in handy. Pronounced Scrcpy, this free and open source program by Genymotion requires only a USB cable and software installation on your PC. All functionality is provided by Android's developer options, and that includes switching the screen off while mirroring, forcing the device to stay awake, or even file and clipboard sharing. All this in an easy-to-install package that is thoroughly documented. I hope that sounds good. Let's begin. Head over to the Scrcpy GitHub repository and click on the latest release on the right sidebar. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and click to download one of the Windows releases. You'll probably want the Win64 version. Once downloaded, extract the folder somewhere safe. You'll be launching the program from that folder. On your Android device, enable developer options. These steps may be subtly different depending on how your device manufacturer decides to mess with the layout of Android's settings, but a typical location is as follows. Go to Settings, About Phone, and tap on the build number 7 times. Sometimes, About Phone is hidden further under a Software Info menu. You might need to do a bit of digging. Anyway, back on the main settings screen, you should see Developer Options at the bottom. Enter Developer Options and enable the USB debugging switch. Now, connect your device to your PC via USB cable. A pop-up may appear on your Android device asking you to allow USB debugging. Select OK, and that's it. If all has gone well, you should now be able to double-click on the Scrcpy executable file, and after a few moments, a console window and your Android device screen should appear. Some users have reported being able to view but unable to control their device. This may be caused by an additional security setting that only appears on certain devices. I've actually had to jump through a couple of hoops on my Xiaomi phone just to enable this option, but it worked flawlessly on my Samsung tablet. In terms of the basics, that's it. You now have a functional setup. But if you want more, here's a hint at how you can do that. Double-click the file, open a terminal here, which should cause a command window to pop up. See, Scrcpy is a command line application, so you specify additional settings by typing in a command. Start by writing Scrcpy and adding a space. Now, you can specify a set of command switches that refer to different options. For example, if you want a higher visual quality, you can write 2 dashes, bit-rate. Add a space and specify a number like, say, 20M, which then sends along a less compressed video stream. If instead you want to force your device to stay awake instead of switching off after an interval, write 2 dashes, stay-awake instead. You can even start a recording. Write 2 dashes, record, and specify the name of the file you want to record to. Of course, there are many more options that can be found on the GitHub page. You can even connect wirelessly, though there is a bit more setup to be done. First, ensure that both your PC and Android device are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Then, in the developer options of your Android device, switch on wireless debugging. The wireless debugging screen should give you an IP address and port combination. Back in the console window on your PC, write Scrcpy space 2 dashes TCPIP equals. Then type in the IP address and port as they are shown on your device. Press enter and you should now be wirelessly streaming and controlling your screen. Of course, the latency is less than ideal, so if that's going to be a problem, consider lowering the bitrate or stick to using a cable. That's all there is for this episode. Go have fun with your newfound screen mirroring powers. Until next time, you're watching 0612 TV with NERDfirst.net. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video and are feeling generous, a donation to this channel will be greatly appreciated. There's a link on screen and in the video description for more details. Meanwhile, please do like, comment, and subscribe. This helps the channel tremendously and gives me the means to do more. Thank you once again, and I'll see you next time.